Hello friend, welcome to my channel 5 Minute Pediatric. Today I am going to discuss about the congenital toxoplasmosis. So most of our viewers have asked regarding the torch infection. So today I will cover congenital toxoplasmosis because we have few torch infection for which treatment is available. So toxoplasmosis is one of them. So let's start with congenital toxoplasmosis. So I will not go in detail how it is, how it affects or how it is caused, and what are the host of this. So let's start how it affects mother. So if mother get infected with that is toxoplasmosis. Okay, toxoplasmosis gondii is the culprit. So in mother, what we say, most of the 90% case are asymptomatic, and if it present, then it present with fever, fatigue, fatigueness, and painless lymphadenopathy, along with chorioretinitis. You may get these are the presentation in mother. So and what? So if we go for screening, so we have two screening tests available. One is IgG. So and other we have IgM. So IgG, it usually appear 1 to 2 week after infection, okay, and peaks around 3 to 6 months, and it persists lifelong in low titer, okay. So we have different tests available: 7-Fedman dye test, direct agglutination test, and these two tests, immunofluorescent assay and ELISA, are usually not reliable. Okay, these two are the good test. Okay, we frequently use the 7-Fedman and direct agglutination test. Okay, now we have IgM. So it appears within 2 weeks and persist and peak around 1 month, and it is undetectable after 6 to 9 months, and it may persist for more than 1 year in some cases. Okay. So if you get IgM positive, so we consider it acute infection, but sometimes it may persist for longer, so that does not indicate an acute infection. So if you get positive or equivocal result IgM, so you have to refer to advanced reference laboratory, because you may get false positive test also. Okay, and what are the treatment option for the mother? So if mother comes to you around 10 to 12 or 13 14 week or just before 18 week, okay, so and you suspect torch infection or send torch profile, and so you have to start spiramycin. What this is spiramycin, okay. So this drug, what is mechanism of action? These drugs prevent or delay vertical transmission. Okay, these just prevent or delay. Okay, once fetus get infected by this torch infection, okay, so it does not alter the disease severity. Okay, so start spiramycin and send and wait for 16 to 18 weeks. Around 18 weeks, go for amniotic fluid PCR. Okay, if it is negative, so negative result does not mean the child is infected. So you have to continue till delivery. Okay, because it prevent or delay vertical transmission. And if it is positive, so you have to give treatment for this. So we have PSL, pyrimethamine, sulfadiazine, and leucovorin or folinic acid. You have to give till term. Okay, and if infection less than 16 weeks, so you most you can advise him for therapeutic abortion, because there is a risk, or if there is severe damage in ultrasound. So if you go for ultrasonography, fetal ultrasonography, you may get hydrocephalus, hepatic calcification, hepatosplenomegaly, or ascites. So you have to go for next 18 week amniotic fluid PCR. Okay, this is about the mother. now mother reaches to third trimester and now baby is delivered. So what are the presentation in neonate? So we have subclinical infection, we have symptomatic, we have delayed onset or sequelae or relapse. So subclinical is the child delivered normally, but if you go for eye examination or CNS examination, you may get chorioretinitis or you may get calcification or some other abnormality you may get. Now we have the child usually comes with symptomatic cases, okay, neonate. So it present with hepatosplenomegaly, megaly, fever, microcephaly, hydrocephalus, seizure, chorioretinitis. So these are the presentation of all the torch infection. So without investigation, you can some have peculiarity. It has tried. We have 3C. First C is cephaly. It has hydrocephalus. Second C, we have chorioretinitis. And lastly, we have calcification, intraventricular calcification. These are 3C tried of toxoplasmosis. It may present as a delayed onset, but present within 3 months, similar presentation. Okay. And may present as a sequelae for chorioretinitis or seizure in adolescent age group. Okay. Now, what are the recommended neonatal tests? So we have IgG, IgM, IgA, and IgE. Rest other you have to go for other basic investigation, CNS examination, eye examination. I'm not talking about this. So I have just for the diagnosis of torch. So we have IgG. If the child is having IgG positive, so usually transplacental spread, because IgG can cross the placenta. So the baby may have the maternal IgG. So it disappears around 6 to 12 months. So if it is positive, so we have again repeat, we have to go for repeated IgG titer. If the titer is fourfold rising, so next step we have to go for IgM testing. Okay. Next, what we have, we can go for IgM and IgA, okay, because it is useful in determining congenital infection, because it do not cross the placenta. So IgG cross, these two do not cross the placenta. So if it is positive, so we have to know the viral sensitivity pattern. So IgM and IgA. So IgM have poor sensitivity, and it's all depends on gestational age, because the sensitivity increased to 50% at 30 week of gestation. But IgAA have better sensitivity in neonate. It rises rapidly and disappear by 7 months. Okay. And similarly, we have IgE. So it rises rapidly and do not persist long. It also usually disappear by 4 months. This disappear by 7 months. This disappear by 4 months. So these tests can be also be used. So if you diagnose, so you have to start treatment. Similar treatment, the mother birth. PSL, we have to give pyrimethamine, sulfadiazine, and leucovorin or folinic acid for 1 year. And you have to go for regular follow-up. PSL cows, sorry, pyrimethamine cows bone marrow depression. So you have to go for frequent CBC. Now, what are the role of prednisolone? Okay, prednisolone, you may be required. So prednisolone is given where there is active CNS disease. Okay, active CNS disease, you can go for LP, and in LP you lumbar puncture and you get protein, CSF protein more than 1 gram per DL. So the child is have active disease, so you have to give prednisolone, or the child is having chorioretinitis. In both these condition, you have to give prednisolone along with PSL. Okay, thanks for watching. In the next video, I will cover about rubella infection or rest other torch infection. Hope so, enjoyed this video. kindly like, subscribe and follow my channel. If you have any kind of query, you can ask. I will try to solve this. Okay. Thanks. Thanks.